What's going on, all my healthcare brothers and sisters? I hope that you are having a wonderful day. We are here to help you pass your NCLEX and nursing school exams like a boss. And today we're going to be talking about our next lab value, which is platelets. Let's get our nurse on. So really, what are platelets? Well, platelets are a tiny disc-shaped piece of cell that is found in the blood and the spleen. Also known as thrombocytes, platelets are pieces of a very large cell in the bone marrow called megakaryocytes. They help form blood clots to slow or stop bleeding and to help with wound healing. Having too many or too few platelets, or having platelets that don't work as they should, can cause potentially serious problems. So the normal ranges when it comes to platelets is between 150,000 to 400,000. If you have a number less than 150,000, that is considered thrombocytopenia. So when we're looking at the pathophysiology of platelets, we know that they are generated by megakaryocytes that's produced in the bone marrow. And the platelet's primary function is to clot and stop bleeding. If the blood vessel is damaged, it's going to send a signal to the platelets. Platelets are going to rush to the site of damage and form a plug, also known as a clot, to fix the damage. Some other important factors that you should know is that clots contain platelets, red blood cells, and fibrin that helps keep that clot formation together. So when we're obtaining platelet labs, we want to make sure that we're using the Lavater top tube with EDTA. Why? Because that's anti-clotting to keep blood from clotting inside. We also know that each test tube has negative pressure inside. So once that needle is inserted into a test tube, the blood should automatically start rushing in. You never want to push blood into a test tube because it causes hemolysis, which is a breakdown of cells and can decrease our overall counts. If we have a decrease in overall counts because of hemolysis, then we're going to treat something inappropriately. Again, something else that you should consider when we are obtaining our labs is we want to have appropriate size needles as well as tubing. At a minimum, we want to have at least a 20 gauge needle for the best results, because that will inhibit the needle's chances of causing hemolysis. So to begin, we're going to look at what are the abnormal values and causes of elevated platelets. Another name for that can also be thrombocytosis, meaning that we have platelets greater than 450,000. So some causes for that include acute infections. So with acute infections, platelets bind and internalize pathogens and release microbicidal proteins that kill certain bacteria and fungi. So platelets assist white blood cells in rolling, arresting, and transmigration of these foreign invaders. We also have something called CML, which is chronic granulocytic leukemia, that increases the production of platelets, but they don't function appropriately. With our chronic pancreatitis patients, they have systemic inflammatory processes that is accompanied by thrombosis and bleeding disorders. We also have cirrhosis, which is an increase in platelet destruction due to stress, leading to platelet aggregation. Polycythemia vera, which we talked about in many of our other videos, which is a type of bone cancer that causes bone marrow to make too many red blood cells. This causes thickening of the blood, slowing down of the flow, and leads to serious complications such as clots. A post-splenectomy is another big cause of elevated platelets because of the increased production of platelets due to surgical trauma and no spleen. So no spleen, no breakdown of old platelets. And then lastly, we have high altitudes and chronic cold weather can increase our platelet counts. Lastly, we're going to look at our decreased platelet counts, which we know before as thrombocytopenia, meaning that we have platelets less than 100,000. So you're going to see this with your acute leukemia patients, AML. Leukemia cells replace the blood-making cells in the bone marrow, causing a decreased production in platelets. Chemotherapy patients will have a decrease in platelets because the chemotherapy destroys cells that grow rapidly, including bone marrow, that produces platelets. DIC, also known as disseminated intravascular coagulation, initially you're going to have this slow evolving process leading to those thrombo thrombolic manifestations, such as DVT and pulmonary embolisms, but then later on, you're gonna have this severe, rapid evolving process leading to thrombocytopenia due to the depletion of fibrinogen and bleeding. Hemorrhage is another one. You can lose a lot of platelets. Infection, systemic lupus, because of that development of antibodies against red blood cells and platelets. ITP, which is idiopathic thrombocytopenia purpura, which is another autoimmune disorder that attacks the antibodies on the platelets and destroys them. A key sign for this that you're going to see with our patients is that petechiae. It's going to be these little red dots underneath the skin. And then lastly, there's certain medications such as antibiotics, NSAIDs, and diuretics that can also deplete our platelet counts. I hope that these videos were helpful for you in passing your NCLEX and nursing school exams like a boss. If you haven't done so already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on that notification bell. That way you're informed every time I post a new video here on Nurse Cheung. Make sure you follow me on my social media. I'm on Facebook and Instagram. And check out my website at www.nursecheung.com, where I've posted additional resources such as NCLEX-style questions to help you pass those exams, resources, cheat sheets, and so much more. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful day, and I'll see you all again soon. Bye.